You've probably noticed that the air does not usually stay put for a very long time in the open. It's moving all the time, sometimes fast and sometimes slow, sometimes in straight lines, and sometimes it swirls around. You also probably know that when there is a fire on the ground and the air moves, that the fire moves too. The faster the movement of the air, the faster the movement of the fire. This video is going to focus on the horizontal movement of the air, or what we call the wind. There are a few other processes at play that affect the vertical motion of the air, but we will cover that in another video. In this video, we are going to look at how wind influences fire behavior and the forces controlling the wind. Wind impacts fire in several ways. 1. Wind dries out the fuel. This is covered more in the videos on fuel moisture, but the short story is that fuel needs to be dry to burn, and wind helps to carry the moisture away. 2. Wind is air, and air contains oxygen, which is a necessary ingredient in combustion. If there's less oxygen, there's a smaller fire. If you add oxygen, you make it bigger. 3. Wind bends the flame over the fuels, which preheats and dries the fuels ahead of the flaming front. 4. Wind influences the speed and the direction of fire spread and the transport of smoke. There are three main forces controlling the wind. 1. The pressure gradient force. 2. The Coriolis force. And 3. The force of friction. The pressure gradient force is the force that starts the wind. It is the movement of the air from an area of high pressure to an area of lower pressure. Horizontal pressure gradients are caused by differences in temperature. Hot surfaces tend to create areas of lower pressure, and cooler surfaces tend to create areas of higher pressure. Because the sun heats the Earth unevenly based on sun angle and surface characteristics, there is always going to be a spectrum of temperatures on the Earth's surface, and therefore, a spectrum of pressures that lead to pressure gradients. The Coriolis force is caused by the rotation of the Earth, and it affects the winds at large scales and over a long period of time. The Coriolis turns the wind to the right in the northern hemisphere and to the left in the southern hemisphere. It is the reason that the winds flow around the large-scale high and low-pressure systems that you often see on a national weather map. The effects of the Coriolis force will be well handled by a general weather forecast. Winds that arise because of differences in temperature in the local area, say the size of a wildfire or a valley or a lake, aren't really affected by Coriolis, so it isn't something we really think about much when it comes to wildfire, even though its effects are always there. The final force acting on wind is friction, primarily the friction caused by the Earth's surface and vegetation cover. The frictional drag is highest at the surface. In fact, the wind must go to zero at the surface because of this friction. The further you go from the surface, the less friction drag and the faster the winds can move. What happens when you add some trees? The more vegetation, the more friction, and the slower the wind. That means that you can have eye-level winds that are 5 miles an hour in the trees and winds that are 20 miles an hour above the trees. What about topography? If you put a mountain in the way of the wind, again, it cannot go through it, so it finds a way around. This can slow the wind down, change the direction, and in some instances, it can speed up. Wind is likely to increase in speed when it is forced to go from wide open spaces through a smaller area, like a narrow canyon or saddle along a ridgeline. This is known as the Venturi effect, and can accelerate a fire through a box canyon or over a mountain saddle. So what does this mean for you on the ground? If you are looking at the forecast and you see 20 mile per hour winds, the winds that you see at the surface may be different depending on your surface conditions and the surrounding terrain. If the forecast says that you will have winds from the southwest, you might end up with northwest winds depending on the topography around you. Looking back to the fire behavior triangle, weather is the most variable element, and wind is the most variable part of weather in space and time. This means that we really need to pay attention and look for cues that the wind might be changing, and plan on how we might respond. In summary, pressure gradient, Coriolis, and frictional forces are constantly working together to determine how fast the wind is blowing and what direction it is coming from. This, in turn, impacts the speed and the direction of fire spread.